Vemelka as a rookie, 13 wins a season ago, goals against average of 3.68. And for the Pittsburgh Penguins, it'll be Tristan Jarry, 34 wins, a 242 goals against average. Those are your starting goaltenders presented by the Hockey Pro Shop. And we can't wait to get going tonight from PPG Paints Arena in Pittsburgh as the Coyotes and the Penguins open up their season. This should be a lot of fun, Tyson. First of six straight on the road for the Coyotes, getting a lot of that Eastern schedule out of the way early.
Let's go. This is what it's all about. I don't care who you are, player, broadcaster, fan, coach, you are excited. This is an exciting time. The slate has been wiped clean. It's time to get it on.
A great look at Sidney Crosby as he's out there to center a line with Jake Gensel and Rickard Rakell. And for the Coyotes, Keller, Boyd, and Schmaltz left to right. Season is underway. We hope you enjoy our coverage here on Valley Sports Arizona. This is going to be played in by Stetcher. Stetcher, one of the new defensemen on the Coyotes back end. Great to see Clayton Keller back out there early, Tyson.
Yeah, horrific injury. We all saw it last season. And that's the big question mark, really. Can Clayton Keller get back to where he was? It is going to take him some time. You know that mentally, the way he goes into the battles, you know, when he gets top speed, all those things play into an athlete's mind when you've gone through something like Clayton Keller has. And I'll tell you what, he worked hard, he battled hard to get back to where he is today. And you just hope 28 goals last season for Clayton Keller that he can get back to that point.
Nick Bjugstad now out for the faceoff against Evgeny Malkin. Talked about how the band is back together here in Pittsburgh and somehow they were able to get everybody signed. Zucker with a shot and that goes over the top and out of play. Head coach Andre Tourigny behind the bench tonight for the Arizona Coyotes. During training camp, pretty happy with where the team was defensively, Tyson. Certainly the offense, they're going to look for more of that this season.
Yeah, he is very happy. He says everything right now is in place. Another year under Andre Tourigny, rookie coach last year. I think everybody fully understands the structure and what coach Andre Tourigny wants out of his group. They are not going to be outworked.
To the line it goes, and a shot. That's blocked in front. Coyotes got in the way of that one. Josh Brown, another young defenseman the Coyotes acquired, able to get it to center before the Penguins bring it in. Brian Russ nowhere to go. Brought out by Nick Ritchie. Boy, this is a heavy line. Ritchie, Bjugstad, and the youngster Matias Michelli on the right wing.
It doesn't stop there either. I can't wait to see this Coyotes fourth line come over those boards. And I'm sure the Penguins, they're looking for it. You knew every guy in that locker room for the Pittsburgh Penguins is looking. Zach Cassian, oh my goodness. I don't want to play against him. O'Brien and the youngster McBain as well that could bring some size.
Mike Sullivan behind the Pittsburgh bench. 507th game as the Pittsburgh head coach. He's number two all time in terms of games behind Eddie Johnston. He'll pass him in really just a couple of weeks. And man, has he done a good job here in the Steel City.
He certainly has. Players, coach, they love to play for him. That is for sure.
Ties, of course, to the Arizona Coyotes. Crosby towards the front and kicked away by Vemelka. Michelli will pick it up. Skated out on right wing. Change on now for the Coyotes and Dumoulin behind the net for Pittsburgh.
You can tell the coach for the Pittsburgh Penguins, he wants to get his big boys into the game early. The second shift already.
Back to the front, they score! And Rickard Rakell, that's Crosby, excuse me. 1-0 Pittsburgh.
As I mentioned, genius work for the Pittsburgh Penguins and their head coach. He wanted to get Sidney Crosby into the game early. He wanted to get this crowd into the game early. Two shifts in under a minute and a half for Crosby already in this game. Puck all the way down the ice. They win the foot race. And nobody picks up the man in front. And that's number 87. You might want to get a body on that guy. And that is not the start the Coyotes were looking for.
Even strength goal at a minute 22 here tonight in Pittsburgh. And the Penguins with a 1-0 lead. Jake Guentzel will get the assist.
Yeah, beautiful play there by Guentzel. He's the one who started it all, won the foot race, won the battle. It always comes down to those 50-50 paddles, Matty.
Later on, the Penguins will get an outcast. Perry Capita, Drew Center, denied, and Liam O'Brien the other way. And brought along, but kept at the line. Joseph with a shot towards the net. That's broken up. Out of the zone, here's Cassian, he's in. Cassian shoots and a stop by Jari.
Oh, what a play there by Mayo. A little bank pass there to Cassian, the big man bringing it to the net.
Guentzel played in behind the net and around the boards, but a good keep of the line by Keller, and now he'll bring it back to center. Boyd tries to play the puck, but we'll get a whistle on the offside.
Well, let's go back, partner, to that play. I believe it was Mayo with the heads-up play, and always have to have your head on a swivel. You get the puck and you're looking to go. And here it is. Gets it head up. He sees Cassian winning the foot race and he takes it to the net. Pretty good opportunity there for Cassian. We got a penalty here coming up.
I believe the Coyotes may be shorthanded here. By the way, the goal and an assist to Chris Letang. So Crosby from Guentzel and Letang.
What's the call here? Still nobody in the box for the Arizona Coyotes, but the penalty box wide open there. They're looking for someone to take a seat.
Might have been too many men on the ice. And so the Coyotes are going to be shorthanded.
Nick Schmaltz going to the box. And here's the Coyotes' first look here at their new penalty kill. New penalty kill that has got to be better. 75% last year on the kill.
Too many men on the ice is the call, and the Coyotes will get it back to center. The penalty kill needs to improve. The Coyotes went out. John Madden, who's one of the assistant coaches who ran the penalty kill last year for the San Jose Sharks, they were second in the NHL. Let's see if the Coyotes can improve in that area.
Yeah, brilliant signing, bringing him over. Special teams are such a massive part of the game of hockey.
Coyotes look for the clear and they can't get it out as Crosby will control. Down low for Malkin. Now Malkin plays it for Rust and this one's going to be broken up and not out.
That puck's got to get out right there.
Now Guentzel and Rust to set it up and we get a puck played with a high stick and the faceoff will come out.
Oh, I don't think the Pittsburgh Penguins like that. Certainly the fans do not. The Boo Birds are out early. And that was a missed opportunity for the Penguins. The Coyotes do not get the puck down the ice. And then the high stick on Rust. And the faceoff will come out.
Malkin and Barrett Hayton. Hayton out there killing the penalty with Dyson Mayo. He's joined by Josh Brown.
And those are the little details of the game. When you're killing penalties, that puck is on your stick. It's got to get down the ice. 200 feet immediately. You don't give this Pittsburgh Penguins team, not with these superstars that they have offensively, another opportunity.
And the details of the game is the faceoff's going to come back. A failed clearing attempt ended up in the Pittsburgh bench. Evgeny Malkin.
Again, that's another mistake. It can't happen. Now you have a faceoff in your own zone.
Off the draw, Crosby. He'll work at far boards. Down low to Rust. Now Crosby to Rust. Gets by the Penguin forward. Back out high to the line. Kept by Malkin and now Crosby with it. Now the Penguins working it around. Letang going to get a great look. Passed along and that was deflected off the stick of Crosby and right to Vemelka.
Yeah, I don't think that was an intended play there by Crosby. It just kind of ricocheted off his stick and on net on Vemelka. And Vemelka knows. Down 1-0 already. He's going to be tested early and often as this Pittsburgh Penguins team is going to look to wind it up.
And they swap out of the penalty kill unit, so Nick Bjugstad in on the faceoff. Kept back of the line. After a Dyson Mayo, he'll pair that tonight with Connor Timmins in 5-on-5. He clears it all the way down. The Penguins are moving along. Still time, a half a minute to go in their power play. They've got a 1-0 lead on the Crosby goal in a minute 22. Carter to Raquel. That's denied by Shelley. And he'll get it out for Nick Bjugstad. Pittsburgh one of his stops, so not too long as he gets a shot on Jari.
Another great signing there for the Coyotes. Bjugstad, another big body straight down the middle. Can't have enough of it.
Out of the corner, and Heinen will get it from the line. This one towards the front. That was deflected away by Shane Gostis there. Kept at the line, Jeff Petrie. Chance and a goal. Jason Zucker, 2-0 Pittsburgh.
Well, that one's going to be even strength. And I think the roof is going to pop off of the building here already in Pittsburgh. They are loving what they're seeing. A few good looks on the power play. Schmaltz comes out of the box, and Zucker left all alone, top of the circle. Going to get that puck, and he's just going to grip it and rip it. Good movement, and here's the shot. Through traffic, through a screen, and that's Big Carter in front. Causing the screen on Vemelka, who never saw that puck leave the stick of Zucker.
Well, a couple of goals early. Crosby and now Zucker. And the Penguins with a 2-0 lead. Over the line, they put one to the front. Oh, just over the top that time by Archibald, the former Coyote, and this one will be cleared away.
This is going to be icing here for the Coyotes, under pressure, trying to find their game. And Andre Tourney, the pregame skate this morning, was some moments. He felt his team was a little sloppy, wasn't ready to go, and he let them have it. And it's filtered in early into the game here tonight. And there's another look on Vemelka. That's one thing the Penguins do. Everything goes towards the net. Never give up an opportunity to shoot the puck.
Getzel chased out of the circle. Crosby comes in. Right in behind the net and around the boards and out. Liam O'Brien will get it all the way back in. Letang is on it now for Pittsburgh. Fell awkwardly. Penalty coming up here. It's going to go against the Coyotes. A delayed call. Dumoulin with it. Cassian on him. The Penguins will bring it out. They get the extra attacker out as Jari to the bench. Gensel. Playing along, and finally the touch by Moser. It looks like maybe a holding call coming up here against the Coyotes and Andre Tourney's team.
I believe it was Zach Cassian with the pressure.
44 minor penalty.
On Letang, was trying to get him as he looped around the net. And I don't think that was the play. That was the secondary play. It happened a little bit earlier on Letang, who went hard into the sideboard. So back-to-back penalties for the Coyotes. First Schmaltz, now Cassian, and a big kill needed. Already down 2-0.
Yeah, 5 minutes and 3 seconds into the opening period. The Coyotes are in one. Malkin back out high. Crosby across to the front. Getzel, he scores. Power play goal, and it's all Pittsburgh early tonight in the Steel City.
Vemelka cannot be happy with the club in front of him. Two penalties, sloppy play in their own zone, and now another power play opportunity, and Gensel doesn't seem to matter, almost down by the goal line. Finds the angle to get this puck up and over in the top part of the net. Tickles the twine, and you look at the puck movement. Crosby to Rust, takes it to the hole, and a nice juicy rebound right there to Gensel and to the back of the net, and all the big boys finding the score sheet early for the Penguins.
Boy, oh boy, Crosby, Gensel, Zucker as well. Two goals in the span of 58 seconds. And a chance in front, and that's blocked away. As it'll be moved along, and the Penguins will look to get it out as Jeff Carter will chase it into the corner. Gostis there. Bugstad for the Coyotes gets it to center. And Nick Ritchie gives way for Mattias Micheli. That's denied. Coyotes are on it. Now Travis Boyd will play it back, and Dyson Mayo has it. 9-3, the shots favoring Pittsburgh. 3-0 on the scoreboard. Comes around to the front. Boyd with a shot. That was blocked. Now it's forced back out. Keller has it. Try to bring it right back into the corner it goes. Schmaltz is on it. Board battle here. Keller, he'll feed it back out high. Moser tried to set it up. It's denied and forced back. Nice play by Moser to get it back to the Pittsburgh blue line momentarily. And now the Coyotes will chase it down. Keller back to center. A little rink wide feed there. Stetcher. It's played around. Pio Joseph can't come up with it. Hayton back out high. Moser with a shot. That rolls to the front.
Well, certainly a shift you want to build off of now. You kind of settled things down. You got that puck in deep and you've gone to work. It's that simple. That's got to continue.
Krause has it. Worked it towards the front. Hayton couldn't handle it. And the Penguins will break back. Zucker. Now Zucker holding for Rust. The shot just wide and high. The Coyotes want a counter here. Christian Fisher back to center. He'll dump one in. And right now, the Coyotes just trying to survive this start, Tyson. Already 3 goals in the first 5-10. The Penguins having their way.
Another penalty right there. Malkin gets clipped with a slash.
Delayed call, touched up there by Cassian.
And again, this is what happens when you get caught on the wrong side of the puck. Another kill coming up.
So the Penguins will go to the power play. Goals by Crosby, Zucker, and Guentzel. They're in command. 3-0 tonight in Pittsburgh.
O'Brien will sit in the box. The Penguins already with a power play goal here tonight. This is a must kill.
Certainly is. And last season, the Coyotes allowed 3 or more goals in the first period 8 times. They were able to come back and win in 3 of those games. It's a whole different beast, though, the Pittsburgh Penguins, and they're on the power play to really bust this one open here. The center for Crosby. And now Rust. Crosby is on it. Broken up by Stetcher. Travis Boyd is in there. Moser and Fisher as well, the penalty kill unit. Play back out high, gets it to the front, just sent along. Goes in behind the net. Coyotes look for a clear, but they can't get it past Letang. Malkin shoots, stop there by Malkin. In the corner, Rust, he'll play it in behind the net, and they rotate it around. This whole power play down in the Coyotes' end.
Usually a power play is a little bit sloppy early in the season. Not here tonight.
Out high to the front, Rust, he can't deflect it past Vemilka.
They are tic-tac-toeing this thing around, and now the Killers are tired.
Across, Malkin, towards the front, denied. Moser trying to get it out, but he can't. Malkin, to the front! And he's denied initially, and the puck ends up in the corner. Letang with 40 to go in the power play, drops it. Down low, Crosby, sharp angle shot, Vemilka kept that up. Another shot, Rust, and Vemilka able to make the save.
Oh my! That is what you call a clinic. That's how you run a power play, zipping it around, you tire out the penalty killers. But also you look at, these are all their best players. Malkin, Crosby, Rust, Guentzel. They're the hardest working players on the ice. They want it. They were winning all the foot races, all the battles along the boards as well. That's a big part of a power play, even though you have the man advantage.
Jeff Petrie, his shot goes wide. All sorts of passing as Petrie will set it up now. As played across, Ricard Raquel, the former Anaheim Duck, to the line. Now Raquel to the front over the top of the net. Danton Heinen to the line. Good keep there by Pittsburgh. Carter behind the net, but this one over the glass and out.
Well, and here's the thing. Now you throw that next unit out for the Pittsburgh Penguins. How do you not follow it up? You just watch your captain, your fearless leader, one of the best players in this game, be the hardest worker on the ice.
Yep.
Now you're like, it just becomes infectious. And you're like, all right, I better go. I better do exactly what he did. And I'll tell you what, he's one of the best leaders this game has ever seen.
Yeah, there have been some great leaders in this league, but I agree with you. In the modern era, I don't know if anyone's better than Sidney Crosby as Raquel comes in for the faceoff. At the line, a shot whistled over the top by Petrie. They got him from the Canadiens in the offseason. Mike Matheson, the defenseman, going the other way to Montreal. The Coyotes will get it out. Back to center ice. Going right back in. We're going to whistle here.
Offside there on the Coyotes.
And now a quick word from 72 Soul.
Hey, hockey fans, thinking about selling your home? Just put in your address and get your price, a higher price, only at 72soul.com.
Tyson down 3-0. What's going on right now on that Coyotes bench?
Well, you chip away. I mean, you're one game in. This is the first game of the year. There's still a lot of excitement on that bench, but you got to chip away. One shift at a time, one dump at a time. Get it in deep. Turn your brain off. The emotions now are probably gone. Get involved somehow, some way. Get a hit, get hit, do something.
Pass to spare. Play it up the boards. Kept. Archibald going after it. Josh Brown behind the net. And brought along, and the Coyotes will get it out. 13-3, the shots right now favoring Pittsburgh. 3-0 on the board. Good intercept there. Brought back in by Schmaltz. A little drop. Gostisbehere with a look, and that's blocked. That's up in behind the net. Big block there by Pittsburgh's Jeff Petrie.
I like the play there by Gostisbehere. Jumping up in the rush, generating a little more offense. That next layer is what you need.
Bukestad behind the net. His stick was broken. No penalty call. He wanted a call. And we roll on as this one will be played back in.
Give us a fucking chance out here!
Well, cover that mic up.
Yeah. Sorry for the language. It happens when you have mics down at ice level.
It's an emotional game.
Yes, it is. Brought in Michelli. Got tugged a little bit. Richie down low. Board battle here with 8:53 to go in the opening period. 3-0 Pittsburgh, in case you're joining us late. Crosby, Zucker, and Gensel, the goal scorers. Maybe a 2-on-1 the other way. Brought right back in. Kapanen with a shot. That's covered by Vemelka. 3-0 Pittsburgh, game one of a 6-game roadie to open up the season tonight from the Steel City.
And Matt and Tyson, after Mike Sullivan's two-question press conference today, still haven't figured out how that works. He's blessed in that regard. I asked him as he walked off to his office, I said, Mike, I've never really asked you about Sidney Crosby. What's it like to be around him day after day after day? And the first word that came to his mouth was inspiration, that he just inspires so many. But Tyson, he also told this story, and I'm going to guess that this is not a shock to you. He said, if there's a moment in a game that didn't go right for Sidney, maybe he had a bad angle on a shot or a pass, it's the next day, before practice, where Crosby is out trying to hone his craft and make himself better, 50 or 75 pucks later, recreating that play so that mistake or that misplay never happens again. And that's the elite level we're talking about here and with Sidney Crosby, right?
You're right. You're dead on. That's how you get to that level. This is a guy that has scored 517 goals in this league, and he continues to work, continues to learn and teach himself and get better every day. And again, how are you not a sponge when you play with a guy like that? You're a Rust or a Gensel. I mean, that's why those guys are so elite as well, because they see the level that Crosby has been at and continues to stay at.
Yeah, the interesting part is everybody thinks there's going to be maybe a downfall in his game. I mean, he just continues to roll. Maybe this is the year. I mean, you hear that a lot. He is.
I've never seen a guy more competitive. All the lockouts that we've had in the National Hockey League, well, he comes to Arizona. I ended up on the back basketball court with him, and he will not lose. And if he loses, he continues to play until he wins. This is a guy that would probably steamroll his grandma in Uno.
I wish I could see Dr. Nash on the basketball floor. Shot just ripped wide by Petrie.
Yeah, it's not pretty, I can tell you that.
Well, Petrie will send it down low. Penguins again in the offensive third. Malkin sent one to the front, and somehow that stays out. Maybe getting a pat on it was Vemelka. Josh Brown at center, and he'll send one in. Whole team's changing out. 7 minutes remaining in this opening period. Right back through center ice, played along by Danton Heinen. Heinen will get it out of the corner, thrown to the front. Good pressure that time by Boyd. And the Coyotes will bring it right back to center. Zach Cassian with it. Cassian last year in Edmonton saw a lot of time with Connor McDavid. And that top unit in Edmonton.
He can play. He's another one of those guys that can play any way you want. It was a head scratcher to me that the Edmonton Oilers let him go. I mean, how? Ask Connor McDavid, how is he feeling without the protection of a guy like Cassian? Look at those eyes. He's got the googly eyes. That is intimidation right there.
We got a penalty called here against the Pens. And P.O. Joseph, the former first-round pick of the Coyotes, into the box.
So an opportunity here for the Coyotes to get on the board. And this is another area that has got to be better. They have got to be better on special teams, and the power play is a big part of it. Last year, they were 30th in the National Hockey League out of 32 teams. And this is an area that, rebuild or not, you still have skilled players that have got to find a way to execute.
Now here we go, chip away, right? That was something that you had brought up just moments ago, and this is an opportunity.
Yeah, you get one here, and all of a sudden, you're right back in the hockey game.
Power play last season for the Coyotes, 30th in the NHL. Trying to improve upon those numbers. Flip back out high. Timmins to Michelli. Youngster working a point here tonight in Pittsburgh. Goes down low. Now Michelli with it. Matias Michelli has some room, and he'll work it back out high. Timmins, cross to the front. Just sent wide by Hayden. Back to center ice.
Pretty good movement here by the Coyotes, but a shot there by Barrett Hayden, who had a real good preseason, by the way. Led all Coyotes in points with 6 in 5 games. You got to hit the net there, though.
Boyd will play it back out high, and Timmins goes across. Michelli. Awesome cross towards the slot. It's cleared away. Connor Timmins will drop it back. Clayton Keller. Cross it goes, nearly taken away. Out of the zone it goes. Coyotes will get it right back. 50 seconds to go on their power play, and that goes off the skate of Petrie and pinballs back. J.J. Moser, new number for Keller. Keller trying to move it along against Josh Archibald. Goes down low for Travis Boyd. Nobody home that time. Gostisbehere couldn't play it, so the puck all the way down.
New look power play here for the Arizona Coyotes. Talking to Corey Stillman last year, he's going to be in charge of this power play this year for the Coyotes. Moser is going to be really the mainstay back there on the blue line, carrying the mail up the ice.
Out of the corner, trying to move it, Brian Dumoulin. And he'll clear it back to center, and the penalty to Joseph is over. So Pittsburgh kills it off, and they're back to full strength. Fisher tried to split the two defenders, comes out of the zone, and Liam O'Brien will send back in. Coming back to help out. He's Jack McBain, and the Coyotes will get it out. Right back in. Opportunity here. Gensel couldn't handle it. Troy Stetcher now for the Coyotes. And he clears it back through center. Liam O'Brien will set away. Joseph behind the net for Crosby. He looks to go quick outlet.
Oh, what a heads up play there, led by Sidney Crosby. Head up the entire way. He knew what he was going to do with that puck before he got it.
Gostisbehere. Now Bjugstad for Richie. Pedersen couldn't handle it. Richie tried to reverse it. And now Rust for Pittsburgh, and he'll get it out. Zucker played it all the way down. He's got one of the 3 goals tonight here in Pittsburgh. Josh Brown. Playing along Malkin. Russ, sharp angle shot. Now Russ back to the front. Zucker is there. He can't get a pass for Malkin. Breakdown in front of the Coyotes' net. They live another day. Now Cassian trying to set it up to the front. Boyd in a glove save charge. Keller and Petrie in the middle of it. A few other players looking to mix it up. It's Kasperi Kapanen and Cassian. And cooler heads are going to prevail in these skirmishes. 3-0 Pittsburgh tonight. Don't look now, Tyson, but the Coyotes are the second youngest roster in the National Hockey League to begin the season.
Well, and you've heard a lot from Bill Armstrong. As young as we are, he goes, it's time. We took a step last year. We want to take another step this year. Young or old, it doesn't matter. You want to get better year after year, and we just showed a guy like Barrett Hayton. This is a guy that obviously has been given a lot of ice time, and it's time for him to step up. 24 points last year, 10 goals. But you have to remember, he's still 22 years of age. And oftentimes you're hard on him, and he's still just a kid and just kind of scratching the surface of hopefully what we're going to see out of Barrett Hayton.
I want to say the Coyotes have only one player 34 or older. That's Andrew Ladd, and he's not with the team right now. He's on injured reserve. So they have certainly gone young. Opportunity shot whistles wide. Jari. Timmins with a great look there as a puck played in behind the net. Krause will take it away. That out high. Now Timmins will play it back in behind the net. Connor Timmins came over in the Darcy Kuemper deal a year ago, but he got injured so early. And got Radko Gudisic in Florida just 5 games into the season a year ago. Didn't really see a lot of Connor. We don't know a lot about his game. This is his 37th in the National League.
Well, he's hoping to stick around and prove Andre Tourney exactly what he can do in this league. And it's again about taking that next step as a player and as a team. And they need some offense from their blue line. They need some offense 5-on-5. That's also an area of concern. We talk about that every year. 5-on-5 scoring, you gotta have it.
You were talking about that big line with Zach Cassian earlier tonight, centering Jack McBain and Liam O'Brien. They've changed it up a little bit here right now. They've got a Cassian out there right now with a Boyd and Keller.
Well, and that's the beauty of Zach Cassian. He can play anywhere in your lineup. He has that ability. He can score. He had 6 goals last season, limited ice time. Limited role with the Edmonton Oilers at times, but he had 19 points. He's a big body, can go to the net, and he is going to create some room and some safety for guys like Clayton Keller and Nick Schmaltz.
Brian Dumoulin with it in behind the net. The Penguins will get it back through center, handled by Vemelka. Big hit there, Moser, Kell all over him. Keller will come away with it. Coyotes look to bring it out. J.J. Moser. Brings it right in, Cassian, and now Crosby into the corner. Took a rough ride from Cassian. Keller trying to win a one-on-one puck battle. Cassian comes in to help out as well as we go. Under a minute remaining in the opening 20 here tonight in Pittsburgh. Stetcher playing around. Coyotes get a clean break out. Nick Ritchie and now Michelli. Matias Michelli, little drop. Gostis there. Across, a shot. That was blocked in route. Boy, Nick Ritchie with a great look there.
Real nice zone entry there by the Coyotes. Michelli, that puck on a string, finds again Gostisbehere joining the rush. So difficult for a forward, a winger in particular, for the Pittsburgh Penguins to pick him up as he joins late.
Matias Michelli brings it in, denied. Malkin trying to go the other way against Gostisbehere. Good back check, Josh Brown, and that rolls right to the net. And we get a whistle, and Gostisbehere that time taking a stick up high. Now some more pushing and shoving, and they're right in the middle of it again.
Yeah, the Coyotes, they go right after Malkin, who they believe was the player that clipped Gostisbehere up high. I think it was accidental. It looked like the man they call Ghost was coming in for the hit. But Ritchie doesn't care. And here's the play. There was the hip check there, and he takes a stick as Malkin goes down, and everyone goes after Malkin, who kind of got a raw deal on that play, but you love it. This is a group that's going to stick up for one another this year. They are not going to get pushed around. They brought in some big bodies, some guys that can play that old school style.
Yeah, and that didn't look like friendly fire. That looked like it was right off Malkin's stick. Geno seems to be fine, and we'll see what penalties come from all of this, which is 12.9 seconds remaining.
And Crosby's talking to the referee there about the hit. Thought maybe it was a little low on Malkin, who is, by the way, a big, big man. Let's see, 6'5", 6'4".
Absolute horse.
Yeah, monster. Unsure this summer, this offseason, if they were going to get Malkin signed.
We have 2 minutes up on the scoreboard, Coyotes side of the scoreboard. And might be Goss to spare, I'm thinking, Tyson. I believe he went straight to the Coyotes' room.
Yeah, with 12.9 seconds left in this first period, that's exactly what happened. So still plenty of time for the Penguins to do some more damage before this period expires. A big faceoff coming up here for the Coyotes. I believe it's going to be Boyd.
Cassian's going to go into the penalty box.
Monty Turney wants an explanation.
What is that, four power plays now in the opening period for Pittsburgh? So a faceoff to the right of Karel Vemelka, just under 13 seconds remaining in the opening 20 here. And they're going to do the faceoff again. Now let's see, maybe a penalty. Looks like a penalty off the draw. Might be an interference minor here. Maybe just a reset of the clock. Hello.
I think Malkin's going. They're escorting him right to the Penguins bench. So he's going to take a seat. I don't know if we got to look at this or not, but off to the locker room he goes. So
yeah, so Cassian got a roughing minor, and evidently they forgot to send Malkin off on the coincidental roughing minor, and so they.
You might want to get him off. He could do some damage.
It'd be a bit of a help there.
A little head shaker there by Coach Sullivan.
It's still showing a Pittsburgh power play. And so we roll on here. Letang brings it across. Rust to the front. Gensel thinking about it. Ends up in the corner. Back out high. Letang shoots. And that was blocked away. And that's going to do it for the opening 20 here tonight at PPG Paints Arena.
So the Penguins still on the power play there to finish that period, and they're going to start the second period as well. So the Coyotes got the extra after all of that, and they're going to need to regroup. Vemelka and company down 3-0. Not a lot to show. Can't imagine the coach is all too happy with his group.
16-4, the shots favoring Pittsburgh in that opening 20. It was all Penguins. Our Let's Go places presented by your Valley Toyota dealers.
That is a road trip, and that is some road warriors here for the Arizona Coyotes are going to be needed. This does not get easier to start the season.
Certainly doesn't. While we have this chance, let's go downstairs. Todd Walsh.
Thanks, guys. As was our custom a year ago, it's great to have a moment to visit with assistant coach Corey Stillman before the start of the second period. And Tyson, it was interesting. He went right to the Pittsburgh Penguins and just recognized what they're doing here. In his words, flying, just moving the puck with ease. But the problem is the ease at which they're moving the puck. And I think we talked about this a couple times last year. You got to get on them early before they start to build that speed and get on the speed. He said, we're not being outworked. We're simply being outskated after one period of play.
Walsh, we talk about it all the time. Take away time and space. And that's exactly what Corey Stillman is referring to in your conversation. You got to take away the time and space. You can't give Crosby, Malkin, Rust, Gensel time to make plays, because you just saw what they will do when they have that time.
Now they had a great first period. Crosby on that first a goal. Gensel with a goal and an assist in the opening 20 minutes as well. So we're underway. It was a double minor to Zach Cassian late in that period, and a single minor against the Penguins. And so they continue on the power play here with a minute 29 remaining in the additional two. as this one will be moved along. Pittsburgh in that opening period, 1-for-3 on the power play with 8 shots on goal.
And certainly not how you want to start this second period after the first period that you just went out and played. Too many trips to the penalty box. You get out of your rhythm.
Gensel towards the front, a shot and a stop. Oh, Crosby out of nowhere. Comes back to the line. Outside of the net, they try to work it back. It'll be Rust. Rust will hold on to it as the puck will be played away. A line for Letang. And now Carter to the front. A stop by Pamelka. And the Coyotes looking to clear with 45 remaining in the power play for Pittsburgh.
Jeff Carter, the fountain of youth, if you will, continuing to get it done and play at a high level. 19 goals for Carter last year, 45 points. A big part of his power play as well with that big frame.
If you go back to his days in L.A., Jeff Carter always seems to do well against the Coyotes. As it's played around, and P.O. Joseph with the key. Sent it in behind the net. Heinen gives way. A shot up high, but Melka the save, and he gets the rebound as well for a faceoff.
Well, that's what the Coyotes needed early in this second period. Have to find a way to stop the bleeding, and Pamelka needs to kick. He needs to be large. He needs to take over this hockey game. Sucks up that one, finds the rebound, and nothing laying around in that blue paint. That's the danger area. That's where you generate second and third opportunities, but not if Pamelka continues to suck those up.
A bit of a problem here, maybe with the score clock. You're talking about trying to get that offense on track too, Tyson. When the Coyotes get back to the 5-on-5, they only had one shot on goal over the last 14:35 of the opening period. Pittsburgh with 27 shot attempts to the 11 put up by the Coyotes in the opening period. So Ricard Raquel here on the draw. That's Jack McBain. Played right to the front. Coyotes look for the clear. They'll get it to the line. And that time Joseph couldn't keep. The penalty is over, so Cassian is out. Coyotes are back to full strength. Cassian has the puck. McBain now chasing it. The Boston College product. Jack McBain. From behind the net. Now back out high. Connor Timmins. Wrist shot. Oh, he hit the pipe. Connor Timmins, and that one was by Jari, but it stays out.
Was it ever? Jari still looking for that puck. And that thing was ripped through a screen. Great job finding that shooting lane. That's what the Coyotes need more of.
Play it along, Keller. Bring it back through center ice. Kraus has it. Try to throw it in front. That time Gostisbehere, and it rolls right to Jari. And we'll get a whistle.
Well, let's take a look here at that opportunity by the Coyotes. And this is what the Coyotes need more of. They stay out of the box. It's a low play to high, D to D, and here comes the shot. Look at all the traffic in front. And that's the beauty of it. When you're a forward, you go to the net, you're going to bring defenders with you. Timmins sees it, he reads it, reacts, lets it fly, gets it to the net. Just unfortunately hit that post.
Chased out of the circle. It's Carter, and now it'll be played around. Carter chasing this one down against Jeff Brown. Played in behind and into the front. Can't finish it off. Out of the line to the front again. Carter was there.
Carter sniffing.
Heinen, backhand, stop Pamelka. Krause will try to get it out, and he clears it back to center. Malkin will send one in. Josh Brown with it. Plays it along. Board battle here. Malkin. Now Rust. Play back through the neutral zone. Malkin will keep. Into the corner, Malkin circling behind the net. And Malkin goes across. To the line, Pettersson shoots. That steered away.
What a play there by Malkin. That was an errant pass out of his reach. He uses his skate to redirect it.
Petrie with a shot blocked away. The Coyotes will look for a clear, and here they come to center. William O'Brien will double it in. Coyotes are going to change. And again, no Nick Schmaltz here in the second period. Upper body evidently not, will not return.
Another real good job there by Vemelka holding the fort. Some big stops. Now the Coyotes outshot 22-5.
Back out high it goes, and Zach Cassian trying to turn to chase, but Oatman Joseph is there for Pittsburgh. Coyotes strip it away. Dyson Mayo towards the front, Raquel, and it bounces right to Jari. Back out high. Chance and a shot by Heaton whistles wide, and it's played by Jari off the end of it. Now a quick word from Gila River Resorts and Casinos.
It's time to own your moment. So you do you.
Zach Cassian, I would imagine with no Nick Schmaltz, his ice time will elevate a little bit here. Tyson, really a guy you can play anywhere in the lineup.
Yeah, absolutely. Big body is going to create some space for some of those skilled guys. And he's an intense man, a big man at that. It's a great signing by the trade, I should say, by Bill Armstrong to bring him over.
I should point out, too, Tyson, Crosby, 2 points so far tonight. He's now one ahead of Alex Ovechkin for the most points by an active player in the NHL.
Pretty impressive.
Yeah.
1,411 points.
That's all.
Not a bad career, and he's still rolling.
Moser will bring it in. Boyd. A little drop there. Krause couldn't turn it. Comes back for Dumoulin. Dumoulin holding, he shoots, and a stop by Vemelka. Coyotes want to come.
And that's a play that just can't happen. You gain the blue line, you turn it over, and 3-on-2 the other way.
Five and Ed Keller. Keller to the line, Brown. Stetcher shoots, and that rides up high.
And listen, I get it. You're down 3-0 against the Penguins. Nothing in this game is going to come easy. But when you're down in a game, you get out of your structure. And plays like that happen more and more often because you're trying to generate offense. You're taking chances.
Getzel has it. Little drop, a shot, glove save, Vemelka. Well, that was a beauty.
Three massive saves by the big man, Vemelka. He seems to found his form.
Karel Vemelka. What a save at the Coyotes' end. Still 3-0 Pittsburgh.
This second period, denying the Penguins an early power play. Big save after big save. The rebound control. Again, kind of finding his form and his rhythm as a goaltender. A big glove save there. Before that last break, 8 shots and really 8 high-end quality scoring chances by the Pittsburgh Penguins.
Settling down, a perfect period so far for Correll. Crosby back out high, and Dumoulin across, and a shot ripped wide by Letang. It'll go all the way back. He played 6 minutes and 20 seconds. By that time, back in the first period of play, the Penguins had already built that 3-0 lead. Goals tonight by Crosby, Zucker, and Guentzel. Crosby with 2 points. Guentzel has 2 points tonight. Good strip there by Hayden. He'll get it out back to center.
Yeah, real good back check there by Barrett Hayden. Good stick. Picks the pocket of the Penguins. Now they just got to find a way to go the other way. Start generating some more offense of their own. Too much time defending. You waste too much energy protecting your own zone.
Connor Timmins plays it along. Lawson Krause. Hang him off that time by Jan Ruda. Now Gostis there, lost it. Carter. And the Penguins will pounce on this before it's picked by Keller, and he'll turn the other way. And Keller tried to flip it along, but a good back pressure sequence there. Rolls all the way back, and Vemelka will flip this one up.
And that's what championship teams are do so well. And the Pittsburgh Penguins aren't far off from winning another cup, but they're so good defensively. On the other side of the puck, as good as they are offensively, they are sneaky good in their own zone.
Move it along. Heinen will send one down low. Jim O'Brien trying to get it out. Helped along by McBain and now forced the other way. Kyrie's looking for a clear here. Walking all over it, but it's moved the other way. McBain getting around Pettersson. Hit along the boards. Rust will play it across. Pettersson. Close to being offside. Comes out high. Petrie across and a shot. Stopped by Mamelka. Square to the shooter. That time it was Zucker. Another shot and a glove save by Mamelka. And all of a sudden, he looks dialed in, Tyson.
Well, the Coyotes, they had some opportunities in the offensive zone. A little bit out of gas. And now all of a sudden, you're forced to play defense. And the second unit for the Pittsburgh Penguins having their way. Zipping it around. Real good chemistry for a team that is playing their first game here tonight in the Penguins. All over the Coyotes again, outshooting them 26-7. Almost halfway through this one.
The Pens win the draw here. Played down low and in behind the net. Towards the front, can't finish it off, and it'll be turned the other way. Fisher, good rink-wide feed, Connor Tibbetts. Play to the corner, Bukestad in behind the net, and Fisher as well helping out. Christian Fisher comes away with it. And Pettersson will get it out back towards center. And fired right back in.
Just too easy there for the Coyotes, finally in the offensive zone. Get the puck below the goal line, which is where they want to play. Big, heavy team this year, that's how they're built. That's where you want to puck, but you need sustained pressure.
Turned the other way by Gensel and now Crosby. Rink wide Gensel. They're just magic together, those two, as Crosby will play it back out high. Dumoulin has it. And now Letang across and Crosby to the front. Oh, and he had a sneak one there for Dumoulin, who was coming in.
Yeah, he was looking for the shot pass.
Crosby again. Back out high. They work it around and stopped by Vemelka on the 27th Pittsburgh shot here tonight.
Well, the Coyotes just have no answer in the defensive zone. The Penguins now go with their top unit, and they picked up right where Malkin's line left off, zipping it around. Too much time and space for number 87 here tonight. He will pick you apart. And there's the shot ultimately by Gensel. Just couldn't find the back of the net. Vemelka standing on his head right now.
Letang, and that's gloved by Vemelka, so we'll get another faceoff coming in.
And really, that's the only area that Pittsburgh can improve at here tonight. They need more traffic in front of the net. They're getting the shots. 28 now for the game. Now halfway through. They're on pace for over 50 here in this one. That is a lot of rubber for Karel Vemelka.
Off the draw, Coyotes will move it along. Richie will dump into the corner. He's out there with Michelli right now. Back towards the front. They can't finish it off. Richie pokes it along, and the Penguins will pick it up.
And the beauty of the game of hockey is the Coyotes get one right here. They're right back in this hockey game.
Now Letang, and back to center ice goes Carter. Carter to the line, but that play goes offside. 10-3, the shots right now in the second period favoring the Pittsburgh Penguins. Karel Vemelka, he's been terrific, facing 28 shots so far tonight. Great things in athletics, academics, and in the community. If so, nominate them for the Bally Sports Arizona Taco Bell Student Athlete of the Month Award. And if chosen, the student and their mentor will be recognized throughout the month on Bally Sports Arizona programs and on our social media platforms. Visit the website you see for more information. Pettersson will send one in. The story here tonight, in case you're joining us late, we know an early start from the East Coast. Crosby, Zucker, and Gensel all scoring in the first 5-10 of the hockey game. The Coyotes try to get get their offense on track, Tyson. We've talked a lot already about Karel Vemelka here in the second period. Seems to be dialed in.
Yeah, you can't feel sorry for yourself if you're the Arizona Coyotes. That's the message on that bench. Go out and work. All about the little things, the details of the game, the 50-50 battles that the Coyotes need to improve at here moving forward.
Malkin, he'll stretch it back through center ice. That's deflected by Fisher into the corner. The minutes gone here in the second period tonight in Pittsburgh. Pass to spare. And he'll move it along for Zach Cassian. McBain after it, Raquel.
Oh, good hit there by McBain. This is where the Coyotes can really take over.
He's gotten additional ice time as the game's gone on. As a shot by Gostisbehere is handled by Jarry.
And how easy is that? Coyotes, they just get that puck in deep. Nothing fancy about that shift. McBain, the big body, gets it in deep. Nice play in the defensive zone first by Gostisbehere, and then they just go to work. Outnumber the Penguins in the corner. They're working, they're hacking and whacking in the trenches. And then they get the shot down low to up high. That is what's going to be available here tonight for this Coyotes group if they're going to get back.
Timmins with a shot and steered away by Jarry. Another shot. That was Liam O'Brien getting it up high with Jarry. Maybe slowly but surely they're starting to get a few looks here on the Penguins goaltender here in the second period.
Well, they've done a better job staying out of the box in the second period as well.
Behind the net, Bukestad gives way for Liam O'Brien. Shot from the point is gobbled up by Jarry as he saw it all the way. That was Dyson Mayer.
Well, we talk about the easiest way to generate offense, and kids at home, if you're watching, win faceoffs. Learn to take a faceoff, and it's not just about the centermen, it's about the wingers too. You win it back, a shot on net, you go right to the front of the net. And then it almost ends up with back-to-back shots there with O'Brien just having his shot blocked. And that's got to be the mentality for this Coyotes group. Shoot first mentality. You can't dust it off. You can't look for a better play. Get it to the net.
Well, they'll do it again here. Boyd gets chased out of the circle, so a Clayton Keller comes in. Keller and the young centerman, Ryan Poehling. No Teddy Bluger tonight for Pittsburgh, so Poehling gets an opportunity. Kluger with an upper body, just kind of a nagging injury. Sent in by Poehling, and in behind the net goes J.J. Moser. Out of the zone, and Keller will bring it along. Across, a chance, and Kraus Van Dyne.
Oh, right idea there. Clayton Keller had that puck on a string. Real nice team pass.
We'll drop here, Archibald, and a glove save by Vemelka.
Well, the Coyotes have kind of quieted down the offense here, or the Pittsburgh Penguins, as you look at former Coyote Josh Archibald with an opportunity.
Second tour in Pittsburgh.
A chance for the Coyotes to kind of catch a breather, regroup, and now come to work. I told you, you can't feel sorry for yourself. You get that next goal, you're right back in that hockey game. As crazy as that sounds, if you've been watching this game, the Coyotes badly outplayed, but they're still hanging around.
Towards the front, steered away by Jarry. Penalty coming up here against Pittsburgh. And the Coyotes will go to the power play.
Well, and here it is, the opportunity they were looking for. Barrett Hayden taken down. It looks to be Carter going to the box, having a conversation
Pittsburgh
with the referee.
77 to miss for hooking.
Not happy with the hooking call. That's a hockey player right there with that smile. Toothless grin. Around the league a long, long time. 37 years of age. Looking up at the Jumbotron. Doesn't like the call, but a nice job there by Barrett. Going to the net. Driving the middle lane. And now the Coyotes, they've got to find a way to capitalize here, Matt.
Power play unit out. Boyd out there. Along with Nick Ritchie. Clayton Keller's going to work the point, and J.J. Moser as well. Now back out high. Now they'll rotate Gostisbehere back out high, and he's got the puck. Moser, now Keller. Across, Gostisbehere shoots, sit wide.
And that's the biggest change right there. Gostisbehere not up high in the umbrella. He is down low on that right side. He's gonna be the trigger man for the Coyotes this year. Big shot, left-hander, can let it fly.
Terrific last season, 51 points to lead the Coyotes defenseman.
Those are very respectable numbers when you're comparing defensemen and the offense that they can bring. 14 goals for the Ghost.
Forced to the line, good keep by Richie. And Keller will send behind the net, nobody there. Petrie sent it around for Dumoulin. Coyotes will intercept, Keller's got it. Now Gostisbehere. The game slows down right now as the Coyotes get it set up. Moser. Now Keller tripped up on the play, and the puck will be moved along and out.
A little bit different this year, not seeing Phil Kessel out there.
Yeah.
Dancing around looking for that shot. He's usually set up where Clayton Keller is on that right side of Jari.
Pacelli. Brings it in. Hayton will get it set up here. Half a minute to go in the power play. Still time. Connor Timmins. He's had a couple of looks here tonight. Played it across. Hayton's there. He shoots in a glove save and a rebound in front of Jari. But he's able to cover up.
Oh, nice shot there by Barrett Hayton. Real sneaky. Comes in off that right wall. Left-handed shot. Kind of pulls that puck in and lets it fly and tries to go short side on Jari and almost finds it. He was looking for that shooting lane, and watch him pull it in, get it around the defender trying to come out and block that shot. And that is exactly how you draw it up, and the Coyotes need more of that.
Hayton will come in here for the draw. Played in behind the net. Penn's looking for a clear. Brock McGinn, and he'll send all the way down. 10 seconds to go on the penalty. Timmins will bring it along. A little drop there from Pacelli. Bukestad, penalty is over. Coyotes trying to maintain possession in the Pittsburgh end. Timmins has it towards the net. That's just deflected wide. Cleared out. Sent back in by McBain. Penguins will force it out. Cassian again on the regroup as he brings it in for Fisher. Fisher to the net, and he stopped and knocked down. Penalty coming up here. Delayed call against Pittsburgh as a shot by Mayo is blocked away. Now Stetcher to the corner. Fisher to the front, fanning on it. And now, still no possession. Comes out high, Stetcher shoots. And finally, the Penguins come up with it.
Oh, that is a burst right there by the Coyotes. What a play by Cassian to find Fisher. Dancing down that left side. What an opportunity. Draws a penalty. And now the Coyotes, once again, Maddie, go to the power play. A chance to get back in this one.
He's got three. Vemelka dialed in here in the second period. Downstairs with an update, Todd Walsh.
Hey, very quickly, guys. I don't know how we top Paul Bissonnette parachuting in on our first intermission, but coming up in the second intermission in just moments, we're going to revisit something we had on our Coyotes Live pregame show, part of an extended conversation with general manager Bill Armstrong and head coach Andre Tourigny on the process of a rebuild, Matt. We'll see you then.
All right, thanks a lot. Looking forward to that, Todd, as Moser's shot is blocked.
Well, I saw that once already. I loved it. Two great interviews. Don't miss it.
Gostisbehere shoots up high, and Jari the save and a rebound. They try to get a pass, Jari, and it's still loose in the crease. And chance here is Keller will send down low, and he gets it right back.
Now the Coyotes are humming. They are zipping it around themselves.
Back to the front, and they score! Nick Ritchie, and the Coyotes are on the board, and it's a two-goal game.
Well, exactly what I talked about, and the Coyotes with, what, two, three real good shifts, five on five, just buzzing. They draw a couple penalties from the Penguins. They go to work. And look at that play right on the stick of Richie, and he just squeaks this one in. And Gostisbehere finds Richie in the middle of the ice. What a play. The big man gets it off just in time, and the Coyotes are on the board, and they're back in this hockey game.
Well, they certainly are. Richie getting his first of the season. The assist, the primary, will go to Shane Gostisbehere, and would imagine J.J. Moser will get an assist as well, as this one is played over the glass and out. Well, that's a huge goal late here in the second period.
And that is where you need your special teams, your power play, to get the juices flowing, get the team back in the hockey game. And there's the man right there, Richie, tickling the twine, his first of the season. What a pickup that was from Bill Armstrong, getting him from the Toronto Maple Leafs.
Yeah, we saw the offense when Nick came over in that deal last year.
Immediately, the impact, and not only the offense, but just another big body.
Christian Fisher into the corner, Ricard Raquel working on him. Raquel plays it around to Letang. This one towards the front, oh, right there against him, but he can't get a pass for Vemelka.
Well, and you go back to Karel Vemelka. Didn't have a great first period, but oh, as he stood on his head here in the second. 3-0 to start this second, and he has given up absolutely nothing. Big save after big save when the Penguins came with a push, allowed his team to wake up, find their offense. And we got a 3-1 game.
13 wins a season ago for Karel in his rookie campaign, and there were nights last season, Tyson, he just simply stole games for the Coyotes.
Yeah, struggled a little bit down the stretch. He ended up starting 49 games last year. That's a lot of games and a lot of rubber that he faced. And he's up for the challenge once again this year, looking to make strides, get better every single game. He now knows the league a little bit better. A year under his belt last year, every arena, every city, every player, really an unknown. Now he's got a little bit better resume on everybody.
Well, the Penguins look like they're going to blow the Coyotes right out of the building in the first 5-10 of the hockey game, scoring three times, but Coyotes have gotten the Vemelka saves here in the second, and they get the Richie goal. Sharp angle shot, Malkin. Malkin trying to work it back towards the front. Zucker's hanging out. Malkin takes it away. Petrie has it right to the front. That's denied by Vemelka. We'll get another faceoff.
It's crazy what happens after you shoot the puck. One shot leads to two, three, four shots on this chip for the Penguins. They look for a response after the Coyotes score their lone goal of the hockey game. And they are not afraid, the Pittsburgh Penguins, to shoot from everywhere on Vemelka. I don't know if that's just how they like to play the game, or they have a read on Vemelka. Maybe his rebound control, where he may be susceptible.
Rust, and now Zucker, that's stripped away. Coyotes will get it out, Keller. Pettersson right to the line. Zucker taken away by Keller, and the Coyotes look to counter. Dyson Mayo. But right now defensively with Connor Timmins. Bring it right back in. Go to work for the Penguins with Jeff Petrie. Dyson Mayo with it. 10 to go in this second period. Nick Richie, the goal for the Coyotes, back at 16-10. Steal here. Crosby back out high. Dumoulin shoots. Pat save. A blocker save that time up high. Karel Vemelka.
Look at Sidney Crosby again. We talked a lot about him here tonight, but does he ever make a bad play? Every play is on the tape. Find somebody that you surprised that he even saw him back door. Whatever the play may be, so much good coming off the stick at number 87.
Gensel to Raquel. Raquel shoots. Stop by Karel Vemelka. Hey, get in the spooky spirit. Celebrate Halloween with the Coyotes on Sunday, October the 30th. They take on Artemi Panarin and the New York Rangers. For tickets, visit ArizonaCoyotes.com/tickets. Mullet Arena,
Can't wait.
Yeah.
Cannot wait. It is going to be buzzing in there.
By the way, good luck to the Arizona State Sun Devils tomorrow as the men's program plays their first game at Mullet against Colgate. Big weekend series for Greg Powers and the group.
Yeah. Good luck to them, is right. Josh Doan, the new captain of the Sun Devils this year.
Yep.
Leading the charge.
The horse will be out there rooting at his son, I'm sure, right?
Oh, you know it. Body painted up, I'm sure.
He'll be holding the fork, right?
I don't know about that.
Play it along. Kapanen goes across. And a shot over the top. John Ruta with a good look there defensively.
Another penalty coming up here, this time to the Coyotes, though.
And delayed call. Malkin in behind the net. They get Jari to the bench for the extra skater. It's broken up here by Cassian and a late power play for Pittsburgh.
Well, let's see who's going.
36, Martin Friendly for hooking.
Gonna be Christian Fisher going to the box. Hook the call. And this is a big kill needed. Christian Fisher, a part of this penalty kill unit, so they'll be without him. But this is a must kill. You can't afford to allow the power play to get the job done here for the Penguins. You quad back into this hockey game. You can't give anything up right here.
Back of the line, Letang. Down low, Malkin. To the front, sliding. A save and a rebound. They score. And I think that's Gino's goal. Evgeny Malkin, it's 4-1.
Well, and that didn't take long. And there's nothing more Vemelka could do on this one. But the Penguins, they win that faceoff. That's the most important part. And Malkin with a beautiful feed. I think he's going to find Crosby back door, and he's right there. Johnny on the spot, the bang home his rebound. Walks out on the backhand. There's Crosby off the foot of Moser, right to the stick of Malkin on the backhand. And he puts it into the wide open net. I thought at first Vemelka made that save, but that was Moser who took that off the toe.
So the Penguins get that three-goal lead right back. Malkin is first at 19-11. Now Malkin to the front. He tries to get a pass for Vemelka, and he cannot. We'll get a faceoff.
Well, and you just knew that Crosby wasn't done. And he gets another point here tonight. So a goal and two assists for Sidney Crosby. Malkin with a tally here tonight, his first of the season, and they're big guns. They're off and running.
Well, that band we were talking about earlier tonight, they're playing all the hits tonight in Pittsburgh.
Yeah, are they ever.
Boy, oh boy.
I mean, crazy to think that it was even a thought that Malkin wasn't coming back. I mean, all they've done is win Stanley Cups here. The hardware that trio has, 9 Stanley Cups between them.
So Malkin from Crosby and Letang. It's a 4-1 game. Tyson Mayo. Now Nick Ritchie, the goal scorer. Plays it across Connor Timmins. 17 seconds to go. Now Steele. Chance here to the front, and Crosby. It's right in the crease, but they can't get a pass. Letang has it. Tang back out high. One final shot as the horn sounds. And that'll do it for the second period of play.
The Penguins, they just keep coming at you. They want to kick this team when they're down. They regained that three-goal cushion again on the power play. Second power play goal of the game here for the Penguins tonight. And the Coyotes, once again, can't feel sorry for themselves. Have to regroup, go into that locker room, and empty the tank here in the third.
40 minutes in the books tonight in Pittsburgh. And the Pittsburgh Penguins getting 3 in the first, 1 in the second. They've got a 4-1 lead. Lone goal for the Coyotes. Scored by Nick Ritchie from Goss, Despair, and Moser. And Nick will be Todd's guest when we return to the Steel City.
Coyotes group.
And it's funny you mentioned his immediate impact, because his first power play goal as a Coyotes player coming tonight since his last score back on the 8th of January earlier this season in a game with Toronto Maple Leafs in Colorado.
That's one thing with this Coyotes group, but how Bill Armstrong has built them. Cactus Tough. You're not going to get pushed around.
Wow. So we have Cactus Tough, Velvet Hammer.
Oh, the Velvet Hammer. That's Lawson Crouse.
Yeah. I like it.
Rewarded with a brand new 5-year contract. Congratulations to him. Well deserved.
Shot over the top of the net, taken that time by Raquel, and it goes out of play. So the storyline in this game. The Coyotes giving up 3 goals in the first 5 minutes of the game, and then they stabilized in the second period. They got the goal from Richie. Karel Vemelka much better. Should make set up for a great third here tonight.
It certainly will. And again, talking to Lawson Crouse, as excited he is about that new contract, he's looking for more. He wants to do it again and bigger and better this year. He wants to score more.
And Raquel rolls it in, and we'll get a whistle and a stoppage.
And that's the beauty of it, and that's what makes professional athletes so great, is they're never satisfied, no matter how much money they're giving them. He wants more. He wants to show the world that he can do it again, scoring 20 goals, which was a career high for Lawson Crouse. He's not done there, just scratching the surface.
34 points, a career high, as Letang took a shot that's blocked in front and a rebound. I don't think that ever got to Vemelka. It went off a skate, and the Coyotes will break back. Costas Bear. Now Hayton plays it around. Michelli gets in the middle of it. Raquel can't clear. Michelli goes to work. Michelli with a shot. Loose in front. That time Richie was trying to hit the trailer coming in. Costas Bear. And it's Letang getting it out.
Michelli's had a nice game for me as well. Coyotes lineup here out of training camp. We saw him in spurts last year for the Coyotes. And the kid can move. He's got hands, he's got vision. He makes plays. The puck never dies on his stick. And it's a real nice combination between him and Richie. Richie's a big body, doesn't skate quite as well, but that's where Michelli comes into play. He's a playmaker. Richie will go in there, work the corners, get the puck, and then find Michelli, who will make the play.
Mayo has it to Timmins towards the net. A stop by Jarry. And Raquel will get it out. Penguins want to change. Coyotes want to move it up. Liam O'Brien can't handle it. Now Pettersson will go after. Not the puck there. Penguins will try to stretch it out back through center with Malkin, but it's taken there by Fisher.
Good back pressure there by Fisher.
Mosier will kick it along. Now Fisher has it. Get it over the line. Boyd trying to play it down low, denied. And Lawson Crouse will go back after it. Only 2 minutes gone in this third period of play, 4-1 Penguins. Keller. Joseph can't get it out. A boy. Moser towards the front. And that one over the glass and out.
And that's really unfortunate for the Arizona Coyotes, who, even preseason, guys in and out of the lineup, and Nick Schmaltz, they're already without their second top point producer from last season. And Nick Schmaltz had 23 goals, 59 points for Andre Turney's group. And hopefully that is nothing significant. Maybe nicked up a little bit. But to start this road trip off, that's one of the last guys you want to lose.
It certainly is. Gostis Bear sends a shot on. Jarry makes the save. Penguins will look to get it out, and they break it back through center. Kapanen. A little dish there for Carter, broken up. Coyotes will counter. And then take it away, and here's an opportunity. Kapanen trying to put it in front. That's denied by Vemelka. And now Cassian back to center. And we'll send one in behind the net. Josh Brown is on it. And behind the net, Goss to spare. We were talking about Schmaltz last season. He was involved in 34% of the Coyotes' offense. That's eighth highest, or was eighth highest in the NHL in terms of single players and the effect they've had on their team. And he is no longer in the game as Petrie.
And again, I mean, as bad as it is, you can't feel sorry for yourself. This is another opportunity that we saw last year. The Coyotes, they were top in the National Hockey League for man games lost. I don't think anyone was even close to them. But this is an opportunity for someone else to step up, someone else to play some extra power play time that they normally wouldn't get.
586 man games lost a season ago, but the silver lining to that, a lot of players getting experience that may not have gained that valuable experience had there not been any injuries. Looking to get it out is Nick Bjugstad and played back to center for Michelli. The Penguins turn the other way as it's flipped in by Brock McGinn. Timmins will play. And now a stretch here for Nick Ritchie. Little drop to the point. Michelli towards the net. Oh, and Jari that time, and look out. Hard to the net was Barrett Hayton.
I'm not sure if Barrett Hayton was cross-checked in or he just lost his footing and went in, but Jari certainly took the worst of that one. Looks like the Coyotes. Oh no, it's the Penguins. The Coyotes penalty box was open. But it is the Pittsburgh Penguins, in fact, that will go to the box. And there's a look at the penalty interference, the call.
Marcus Pedersen's going to have a seat. Barrett Hayton back to the bench.
Pedersen just kind of clipped the left leg of Barrett Hayton and took him out, lost his footing. And it's a dangerous play, almost hurt his goaltender on that play. Goaltender's in a very vulnerable position.
Go to the power play here as it's rimmed around and out. Moser will play it in behind the net. And now Keller will bring it along. Travis Boyd. Ritchie.
Boyd's been a little quiet here tonight. Get an opportunity as this game clicks along. A real nice season last year, career highs, I believe, for him as well. 17 goals for him.
Keller back through center. This one back to the point. Moser will get it set up here. Goss to spare. They work it back out high. Shane Goss to spare. Floats one across. Keller. Goss to spare to the middle. Ritchie scores! Second of the night, Nick Ritchie. And it's a 4-2 game.
That is dirty. Absolutely dirty. And Jari's jockstrap hanging from the rafters here at PPG Paints Arena. What a play. A mirror image of the Coyotes' last goal. Same identical play. What a pass by Goss to spare to find Ritchie in the middle of the ice. And he pulls Jari right out of his shorts. Look at the play. Little pump fake. Walks right around him and just slides it into the empty net. That is a thing of beauty.
They're really a carbon copy. And that time it was McGinn late, getting back late. And before that, the first goal he scored, Brian Rust, and was nowhere to be found. So the Coyotes cut the lead to 2. Mayo in the corner. Letang has it. Back out high for Dumoulin. Now Letang. Mikkel may work it around. McBain tries to go up the boards. He can't clear it. Letang sent across. Nobody there. Liam O'Brien will get it out.
And you got to give Corey Stillman a little credit there. Certainly a planned play right there as O'Brien just gets lit up. And that was Letang with the big hit. I think gets a little bit of payback. O'Brien's been running Letang every chance he has gotten on the forecheck, and Letang lets him have it.
Letang's been involved in some big hits through the years against the Coyotes. Remember the Shane Doan?
Yeah, that was bad. That was ugly.
Shelley. Trying to flip it along.
But what execution again on that power play by the Coyotes. And all three of the Coyotes players will get on the score sheet once again. Moser, and Gosses, Bear, and Richie.
Rust has it. And he cuts in behind the net for Malkin, who sent it wide. That'll be brought out by Michelli. He's bringing it along, Keller. All right, back for Lawson Krause, who will dump one in. We'll get one here, Tyson. All sorts of time. 13 and a half remaining in a regulation.
Yeah, that's exactly right. That's the message on that bench. You hope you get one here, and Pittsburgh puckers up a little bit.
We'll drop Keller with it. Keller has to bring it out. Across it goes. Boyd couldn't handle it. Penguins will bring it in. Heinen, little drop, Kapanen. To Heinen, shoots and a stop from Elka. We got a game here in Pittsburgh in the third period of play. Nick Ritchie with his second of the night. Power play tally. Also have some hits, big hits. Letang and O'Brien. 4-2 lead, some offense, some goaltending as well.
Absolutely. This game isn't even close without this man right here, Vemelka. A little bit of a slow start, or maybe a better start for the Pittsburgh Penguins in that first period, but down 3-0, and he has almost completely shut the door, if not for that last power play goal by the Pittsburgh Penguins. You hit the four mark.
Vemelka tonight, and the other story, Nick Ritchie, fourth multi-career goal game for Nick.
How good does that feel, getting off to that kind of start?
First time in his career, by the way, that Nick Ritchie has recorded two power play goals in a game.
I typically didn't get my second goal until about Christmas. So I can't imagine how excited he is.
Two more than I ever scored. Play it along, right back to the front. Not trying to redirect that off his stick. Gensel. Crosby in the corner. And Stetcher will skate it back. Right around, Barrett Hayton with it. Hayton's got some room. He takes advantage. He shoots. Big save, Jari.
Oh, there it was right there. Penalty coming up too now against the Penguins.
That's the spear with it towards the front. One off Zach Cassian. And over the glass and out of play. A slashing call. And that's going to put the Coyotes on the power play.
Oh, real good patience there by Barrett Hayton. And it's going to be Crosby, the Penguins' fearless leader. A little whack on somebody. But real nice patience there by Barrett Hayton. Given the ice, he takes it. And he makes one heck of a play. And almost finds the back of the net. Nick Sullivan is not happy with that call at all. He is old furnace face behind that Penguins bench.
And one of the more animated coaches around the circuit.
Oh, he's passionate, boy.
He's done a tremendous job here in Pittsburgh.
A little sell job there by Michelli.
If you're not selling, you're not trying, right?
Oh, yeah.
There's always a buyer. Moser has it.
Oh, now you really want to do some damage here. This power play has been good here tonight. Both goals here for the Coyotes.
And Nick Ritchie is out there. He's got both power play goals, as we mentioned. This one will be cleared away and out. And you score here, Tyson, one goal game. You shorten the game. You have an opportunity down the stretch. Sharp angle shot, Keller. And now back out high for Moser. Gostisbehere, and into the corner it goes, behind the net. Boyd. Big battle here. Kapanen's in there. Root is in there as well for Pittsburgh. Richie, Boyd. Now Richie frees it. Gostisbehere will get a look. It'll flip out high. Now Keller over to Gostisbehere, shoots that one off a stick.
And that is where they want the puck, right there in the hands of number 14, Gostisbehere. He is that guy that slows everything down.
Boyd got tackled. Played around, Gostisbehere and out high. Good movement here for the Coyotes on the man advantage. Keller flips it along. Richie broke his stick and it pops in front. Now the Penguins are going to bring it out. Shot by Archibald is denied, and we get a whistle here. It looks like maybe a penalty coming up against the Coyotes.
Yeah, I think you're right. So give this one.
Arizona 14, Martin Crowley for
give the credit to Mike Sullivan on this one. Maybe it did pay off the animation behind the Penguins bench. It's Gostisbehere to the box, and that's where you have to know that you got to keep your stick to yourself. You can't give the referee an opportunity to give you one. Little whack there on the left leg on Josh Archibald, and to the box you'll go.
Yeah, that's something they call quite a bit. So 4-on-4 for the next 18 seconds. And Mayo has it. We'll look to skate it out. Christian Fisher. Now Fisher will crank it up. 7 to go in the penalty for Pittsburgh. They'll go to the abbreviated power play. Played around Gensel, and now out of the box is Crosby. So the Penguins on the power play. Crosby obviously will stay out. And he's got the puck as he cranks it up to center. Over the line, Gensel. He's got a step, a shot, and a stop by Vemelka.
Again, sucking it up, Vemelka. Short side, Gensel tries to just elevate that over the blocker of Vemelka. He's a big man. He's hoping he goes down, and that'll leave the top corner open. But Vemelka with another big stop, and that was Crosby finding Gensel far side, rumbling down that right side. This line has continued to be all sorts of problems for the Coyotes here tonight.
The faceoff, Coyotes will pick it off, and Lawson Crouse will clear it out. Crouse had one of the three shorthanded goals last season for the Coyotes, along with Louis Erickson and Clayton Keller. Crosby, and now Rust. Letang has it, trying to work it around, broken up by McBain, forcing it back.
Great stick there by McBain. That's just hockey sense right there. He knows that Letang wants to, and really his only passing option is D to D, takes it away.
We're talking about Michelli's night. I think McBain quietly has had a good night as well as this one towards the front. Now Crosby with it. Stetcher will take it away. And he'll just drag it along and dump it. The Coyotes are going to change. Half a minute to go in this Pittsburgh power play. For Heinen. Now Heinen gets it back from Zucker. They'll wrap it around for Carter. Heinen now. Zucker! He fired it over the top.
Almost took out Carter's head behind the net.
Heinen with it. 5 to go in the penalty. Puck comes out high. Petrie. Raquel shoots, and that rides wide. Gostisbehere out of the box. Coyotes will skate it out. Coyotes changing it up, getting out of that penalty kill situation, and they get everybody reset. And Keller out there as he'll drop it back. Timmons. And Keller's got it. 7:45 remaining in regulation. Play behind the net. Stetcher pokes it along. But a line. Across. Stetcher. Worked it to the front. Cassian was there, but he can't get a shot away. Ruda for Pittsburgh. We got a whistle here on the icing. A lot of haven't had a lot of icing calls here today.
No, we certainly haven't. And the Coyotes will gladly take this one. Because of that icing, that puck and that faceoff is going to come into the offensive zone. You're down by two. Every faceoff matters. The Coyotes have been schooled in the circle here tonight. They have to find a way to take over these faceoffs. You have to start out with the puck. You can't afford to chase with 7:29 left in this game.
Off the faceoff. Coyotes pick it off. Michelli goes into the corner, sent around by Hayton, trying to set up the point man. Down to the corner, Richie behind the net for Barrett Hayton. Theo Joseph is there. Coyotes pinch, and they keep the play alive. Here's a chance. Moser, and it's blocked away. That was Joseph. Michelli to the front, a shot. Oh, and a point blank save. Hayton is robbed as the puck ends up into the corner.
Oh, how many good looks has Barrett Hayton had here tonight? You can't buy one.
Pass to spare. Michelli.
Oh, these two go to work.
Oh, Dangleitis.
Bad case of it. It's going around.
The zone and moved along and played in by McGinn. Not a little restless here tonight in Pittsburgh. 6.5 remaining.
Well, they can feel it, as can the Coyotes.
McBain has it. McBain trying to pull off. Big hit there, Dunaway. And Dumoulin will skate it out. Mayo for the Coyotes. And Crosby and William O'Brien. O'Haley from Atlantic Canada. Tang. We'll flip one right back in. Coyotes have numbers, but it's stripped away by Rust. Josh Brown. Pounded there by Zucker. Here's an opportunity. Boyd. Now Kraus for Keller. Gonna try to work it back out high. Stetcher, his shot blocked. Gets it right back. Stetcher, wrist shot. Loose in the crease. Coyotes whacking away at it. Ends up in behind and at the effort here in the third period. Well, they've had looks. This one has moved along. Now Malkin takes it. Malkin cuts to the front. Across and a stop by Malka. In the crease and it goes in. Somehow that squirts in. And now, oh, heck breaks loose.
They got that right, and for good reason. Of face rubs and stinky gloves in the face.
And that's Jan Ruda and Lawson Kraus.
And I gotta think that they're gonna look at goaltender interference on this one, as Vemelka ended up on his back in his neck. Just got steamrolled. The Pittsburgh Penguins, they just keep coming at you. They're hacking and whacking. Here's a look at it. Malkin gets the puck, takes it to the net, goes around Kraus and kicks it out to the side. And I think this is going to be a good goal. And the Coyotes took exception. Who's that? Ross standing over top of Vemelka with the celebration. He'll take a look right here. He's given it to Barrett Hayton, I believe.
It'll be a challenge here, Tyson.
Well, let's take a look. That left pad of Vemelka comes out, kicks that puck. And certainly a lot of bodies in that blue paint. I think this is going to be a good goal.
And if it stands, it's 5-2 Pittsburgh. And it does. Thomas gets his first of the season. As the puck will be moved along, Brian Coyotes go back to work. Russ gets the goal. Zucker and Pedersen the assist. Played on the line, Josh Brown will send it right back in. So the time of that goal, 15:01. As the Penguins back in front, 3-3 at 5-2. Kelly will take it away. Nine different Penguins tonight with a point.
They certainly spread the love around in this game tonight. Started early and
Michelli got stripped of the puck and brought out by Letang. And denied. 3:47 remaining in regulation. You know, really, you just go back to the start, Tyson. Three goals in the first 5:10.
And the Penguins. The guy you feel sorry for. They just hit 50 shots. Is the goaltender here tonight, Karel Bamalka? I mean, they got five by him, but this guy stood on his head, stood on his melon, and allowed his team to get back into this hockey game.
That's the spear falls down. Now Zucker behind the net. Out high, Malkin snapped his stick. Gostisbehere will join the rushes. It's brought out by McBain. Played right back in. Coyotes are going to change. And no doubt, Karel Bamelka last season saw a lot of rubber. And he's seeing a lot again here tonight as the Penguins have reached that 50-shot mark. In behind the net. Played around, a chance there. And a stop by Bamelka and a bid by Kapanen. Don't like each other right now. Sidney Crosby, 1.45 points per game. And you go back to 1996, nobody better.
Absolutely ridiculous.
Against the Coyotes.
35 years of age, continuing to get it down, a goal and two assists here in this game, and it's started on the second shift for him here tonight. Got his team off and running, and that's what great leaders do. They lead by example. And you look at the group that he is in, and that is something special. And he has thrived on playing against the Coyotes over his career.
Impressive numbers. And again, no drop-off in his game. Absolutely no. Carter there against McBain. Coyotes come away with it. McBain has it. He'll bring it in. Now the Penguins will go the other way. 2-on-1, led by Danton Heinen. Heinen to Kapanen. He shoots. He scores. Barry Kapanen, a late goal to make it 6-2.
Oh, and a ridiculous goal. A turnover by the Coyotes just inside the offensive blue line. And they just hung the big man out to dry here late in this game. And Kapanen gets a beautiful assist by Heinen. Look at this pass. Right over the stick. And under the bar by Kapanen. Head up the entire way, brings the defenseman towards him, and that puck gets up in a hurry.
On the boards in the final couple of minutes here in the third period of play. We play it out. Joseph racing after. Coyotes will continue this season-opening six-game trip on Saturday night in Boston. Behind the net, Kaling will get it out, clear back to center ice.
Pittsburgh.
Timmons lead pass. Got to set it up there for Fisher. It rolls right to Tristan Jarry. And now a quick word from 72 Soul.
Hey, hockey fans, thinking about selling your home? Just put in your address and get your price, a higher price, only at 72soul.com.
Christian Fisher, he's had a couple of looks here tonight.
Yeah, he has, and another guy who's played extremely well tonight for the Coyotes and hasn't been able to buy one is Barrett Hayton. Yeah. He has had some real good looks from scoring areas, just didn't find the net.
Similar, kind of maybe picking it up from the preseason schedule. He led the Coyotes in the offense. Carter behind the net. He's locked up there with McBain. And 14 remaining in a regulation. And again, it's a case where there were parts that were pretty good, Tyson, but just not enough.
Not enough sustained pressure. You dig yourself a hole early in the game, and it just... it comes back to haunt you. It really does. You get out of your structure, you get out of your system, and you lose guys. You spend too much time in the penalty box against a team like the Penguins, and you lose guys like Clayton Keller, Nick Schmaltz when he was in the lineup early in the hockey game. I mean, some of the guys that don't get on the kill lose that rhythm. They don't touch the puck. Those guys need to touch the puck and find a rhythm.
That is a follow-up to what you just mentioned about Nick Schmaltz. Gone after the first period of play, upper body. And we'll keep an eye on that as the road trip moves along to Boston. I mentioned the fact that Nick involved in 34% of the Coyotes' offense. That's eighth best in the National Hockey League in terms of effect on the individual teams as Petrie will play it. He's been good tonight for Pittsburgh. Half a minute to go as the puck will be played behind the net. Vemelka. Now the Coyotes will bring it out. Matias Michelli. All right, Tyson. He rarely dies the puck that is on his stick as this one will be moved along. And back through center ice it goes. Kapanen. Play to the corner for Danton Heinen. And 10 seconds remaining. A lot of the crowd is left PPG Paints Arena. The rest of them on their feet. And it'll be a successful opener to the season for the Pittsburgh Penguins. 6-2 they defeat the Coyotes tonight. As the Coyotes now will regroup and get ready for Boston.
Well, that's exactly it. You have to regroup. Go give your goaltender some love because you kind of hung them out to dry a little bit here tonight for the Coyotes. Back to the drawing board. Can't feel sorry for yourself. Get some good food in you. Refuel and get ready for the big bad Boston Bruins.
So the Coyotes drop a 6-2 decision in Pittsburgh. Richie with both goals. More when we return.